There we go. Well, I'll fold, aren't you? Let's go.
At a scrapyard in Grimsby, the carcass of a condemned boat is about to be butchered.
Like being in Barbados when you put them on.
I know. Freaks sun out, doesn't it?
Weighing in at 29 tonnes, this retired yacht could provide the scrap kings with a hefty payload of resaleable steel. To get the booty in the boat, they're bringing out the burners.
So the plan is just to get a nice big piece out of it so we can see inside. Then we'll get inside then. We can see exactly where we're cutting. Man versus machine, that's the one, yeah. Yeah. Man always wins though, doesn't he? Seen Terminator, haven't you?
Butch and James set to work, slicing through the steel. Wayne's on standby with the hose to dampen down any combustible cabins.
But you can see which is fastest cutter if you look at James's face and look at Butch's face. Butch is flying, isn't it? I better get back inside on fire watch because I don't want any fires happening.
It's not long before first one... And then a second part of the steel hull is scuttled.
See now, can't we? See what we're doing now. Happy days, mate, happy days.
With one side of the hull cut out, it's time to ready about, flip the boat and go again.
I'll go get machine now, then bring it round.
Well, I'll put this piece out.
No worries.
Wayne fires up the excavator and pulls alongside for a broadside. The Scrap Kings have an almighty battle on their hands. When Wayne offers up the grab to give the boat a shove...
I can't grab out, you know what I mean? There's no I can grab, nothing at all.
Wayne's digger arm and grab can't get a good grip. And each time he tries to upend the boat, it simply rolls back to where it came from.
We need someone to stop it rolling back towards me, you know what I mean? Okay. If you got someone to stop it rolling towards me, I'd do it in 2 seconds.
I don't want to give up, does it? It's a bit of a fighter, isn't it? Won't be for much longer, though.
This boat's not rolling over for anyone. Time for plan B.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'll just lay it back down, we'll do it from inside.
At least you'll be able to do other side as well, then.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And, do it like that, then, Butch.
Lay it down, yeah.
All right, Matt. Watch yourself.
Rather than flip the boat over, Wayne simply dumps it on its side. Now they'll be able to burn through the rest of the hull from the inside out.
At least I can see what they're doing now. Now they've got a piece out and they're inside and they're working inside. You can see where you're cutting, so you're not meeting any obstacles along the way. Tried best I could, but the boat beat me this time, didn't it?
Great, well, that boat doesn't work.
Never mind. We'll live to fight another day.
The demolition of this old pleasure boat has had its fair amount of pain. But after 48 hours of pulling, pushing, breaking, and burning, the Scrap Kings are on the final straight.
I reckon we should have it done in another couple of days. We're not going to make a fortune out of it, but that's a scrap job for you. You don't win on everything.
I don't think we'll make a million, like, but might make a bob or two. Maybe.
This once very super yacht might not make them rich, but the Scrap King's scuttling skills will at least keep them afloat.
Yeah, we're getting there now. She's starting to bend to our will.
In Lincolnshire, a burnt-out tractor is about to be transformed into a resaleable stash of spare parts.
That'll do.
It's taken two diggers to get the John Deere 6930 through the door, but they're almost there.
If at first you don't succeed, try and try again.
After 71 years playing with tractors, Keith Lee is now an expert in taking them apart.
71-year-old, two new imps I've had.
I feel sorry for him.
Yeah, two and bionic. Yeah, unlike the tractor. I think when I'm cremated, these are up there at the crematorium door waiting for the scrap, my titanium out my legs, I think. Yeah, yeah, anything will be sold.
Everything's got a price.
They'll sell their own grandmother.
Right, Keith, we're off.
Over there?
Yeah. Every component that's salvaged will be inspected, cleaned, catalogued and priced up for resale.
Disconnected the drive shaft now, I've took the bolts out.
I'll cut the front ones off, I think.
Yeah. Take one out, just leave it on the slack. Then we'll get the chain round it and lift it out.
Once it's retrieved, the retired tractor's engine offers a multitude of separate components.
That's spaghetti junction.
As long as they're in decent working order, everything from the bearings and pistons through to the gaskets and crankshaft can be removed and resold.
At the moment of truth, this is. Are you ready, Tony?
Tony surgically removes the mechanical heart from its carcass. This tractor may be dead and buried, but its components could breathe new life into dozens of others across all corners of the globe. It's a team effort, but it's crystal clear who's in charge.
Keith is the man. What he don't know about tractors ain't worth knowing.
My money's going up.
I'm trying.
Try it.
But when the back slapping stops, it's time to get back to work.
So we're now going to remove the wheels. Pretty heavy they are.
Yeah.
Slowly but surely, the burnt-out chassis releases its treasures. The final jewel in the crown, the drop box that controls the four-wheel drive. If you're prepared to work at it, you'll find treasure amongst the trash.
Even though it's been in a fire, it's perfect. Your job done, that's it.
A tidy pile of resaleable parts can go from the workshop into the shop window.
This sort of tractor is very popular, so within a few days it will be out, sold and back on tractors, working again. We sell these parts to 53 countries, so things that were basically ready to go and be thrown into the scrap bin in the sky get brought back to life, and they go again for another 10 years even.
Not bad for a couple of old boys with some spanners.
And this is how what I really look like. Look, we're having a hat on, that's it. This is it, we've done it. 71 year old and still doing it. And some of these young ones can't even get out of bed.